Yes, this is a follow-up video to the first one I posted. And this is also to prove to you that there's nothing like HIV. That HIV is a scam. This man explained it better. HIV was created, the lies was created to make money and to kill our people with their antiretroviral drugs. Listen and share widely. I told you that not but ourselves can free our minds. But a lot of you did not get it. Listen.
HIV AIDS, the greatest lie of 21st century.
You hear that?
HIV, the human immunodeficiency virus, cannot cause AIDS. You may be surprised to know that HIV, a kind of retrovirus, cannot enter your body through blood transfusion, sexual contact, or by any other means. Don't believe me? Give me 5 minutes. You will believe.
Okay.
The discoverer of HIV, Luc Montagnier, the Nobel Prize winner, he has clearly established that HIV has never been found in the human body. In fact, in last 35 years, since the time you were told that HIV causes AIDS, there had not been even a single research paper to prove that HIV is found in the human body. You might be thinking, if that is true, then why and how the doctors diagnose HIV AIDS? When the doctor diagnose, they use this kind of kit, HIV diagnostic kit. But look carefully, it is not an HIV diagnostic kit. Actually, it is HIV antibody diagnostic kit. Antibody is something, a kind of protein, which is produced by your body. And it is having nothing to do with HIV itself. Even the PCR test invent.
Listen to him. He said it's a kind of antibody, a protein our body produces when we are sick or when we have external thing acting in our body. It's kind of defense system. Dr. Sebi calls this mucus. Our body generates mucus to reacting to the sickness that is in us. And that's why when they test it, it tests positive and they call it HIV. It's nothing external, it's within us. The first woman I shared a video said it, and this Indian is saying it too. So just listen.
PCR test is the kind of test which is used all over the world to detect HIV. The PCR test inventor, Kerry Mullis is also a Nobel Prize winner. His invention is not meant to test HIV. His invention cannot detect HIV at all. In fact, it is HERV, human endogenous retrovirus, a kind of virus which your body produces on its own during the time of illness. When you are ill with tuberculosis, pneumonia, diarrhea, certain kind of cancer, flu, even sometime during pregnancy, your body produces HERV. At that time, if you go for such...
Yes, because when a woman is pregnant, she has 50% of the gene of her husband in the baby. And that is a kind of a strange thing in her system. So her body generates this antibody that tests HIV positive to fight that strange body in her system. And that's why pregnant women are likely to test HIV positive. Listen to it. I have listened to a lot of doctors on this research, and it's the same thing they are saying, and they are from different continents. But meanwhile, they have killed a lot of Africans with their antiretroviral drugs, which is the causative of AIDS itself. And they tell you have to take it to kill, to reduce the viral load. No, they are introducing the viral load in your system. I know a lot of you are going to argue this with me, but before you do, take your time to research it, because I've spent time on this.
This kind of diagnostic test, you will be tested as HIV positive. The truth is that when you are ill, body produces such kind of retrovirus, and once the illness goes, these HERV also
goes.
But once you are tested as HIV positive, although it is false HIV positive, the doctors will prescribe you AIDS medication. It is these AIDS medication which causes AIDS. So these are kind of AIDS medication. AIDS is acquired immunodeficiency syndrome. It is not a new disease. It is a new name given to the collection of 29 already familiar illnesses by CDC, Center for Disease Control, US. And which are those 29 illnesses? That include tuberculosis, diarrhea, certain kind of cancer, certain kind of flu, pneumonia, etc. It's a big scam. Very, very big scam. The greatest scam of humanity and the second most profitable business.
Listen to him.
Some of you may be knowing the most profitable business in this world is the business of religion. Because when you donate any money in the name of God, when you donate any money in the name of prayer, that money do not go to the God, because God is non-existent.
Yeah.
It goes in the pocket of those who propagate the religion. In the same way, the money which is allocated or donated or collected for HIV AIDS prevention or cure or research do not go anywhere, because HIV AIDS does not exist in reality. So it goes directly in the pocket of those who are involved in the propaganda of HIV AIDS hypothesis. And those people include CDC of US, FDA of India, IMA, Indian Medical Association of India. FDA and IMA, this is the body who had been stopping me on several occasions to tell the truth, to reveal the truth of medical science, to show the real face of medical science. On 8th April, a day after the World Health Day, I'm going to expose this hypothesis with the launch of my book, HIV AIDS, the greatest lie of 21st century. My challenge to FDA and IMA on that day at 11 a.m. in Hindi Bhavan, Ghaziabad, you bring one HIV patient, a patient whom you claim to be HIV positive, take out his blood, and I volunteer myself in the presence of media, in the presence of public, I allow you to inject that blood in my body. If HIV AIDS hypothesis is true, then after some days, I should be detected as HIV positive, and eventually I should suffer from AIDS, die of AIDS. I invite all of you to join me on 8th of April at 11 a.m. in Hindi Bhavan, Ghaziabad. And if you cannot come physically, even then you can connect with me through Facebook Live. If you need that book, I can send you the ebook. You just send me the request through my email. Spread this message to free the nation of the economic and social burden of HIV/AIDS. All the best. Jai Hind. Thank you.
Thank you very much, sir. Thank you. Thank you very much. I know my black people will not listen, but maybe because you have a lighter skin, they might listen to you. So you all have seen that there's nothing like HIV, that is just a propaganda, that the killing agent is actually in the antiretroviral drugs they give to you. I have always known this because I've seen families that they say the wife has HIV, the child has HIV, but the man is okay. I have seen where they say the man has it, but the woman is okay. And I was worried. That took me into this research. And I'm convinced that Jesus Christ,